Welcome to Taiwan News. I'm Viet Cuong. Today's headlines. Chairman of Taiwan Provincial People's Committee welcome Vietnam Ambassador to Sri Lanka. Leaders of Taiwan Province welcome delegation from Jetro, Japan. International Conference on ASEAN-South Korea Economic Cooperation. On the morning of December 25th, Mr. Zheng Ngoc Long, Deputy Secretary of Taiwan Provincial Party Committee, Chairman of Taiwan Provincial People's Committee, welcomed Mr. Ton Sing Thanh, Vietnam Ambassador to Sri Lanka. At the meeting, Mr. Zheng Ngoc Long presented the current economic, cultural and social development in Taiwan Province, especially highlighting the areas with cooperative potential such as industry, agriculture, forestry, agricultural production, education and information technology, etc. He also requested that the ambassador continues to introduce Sri Lankan companies to come explore and invest in Taiwan Province's industries, especially in the tea production industry. The ambassador in return expressed his gratitude towards the provincial leaders for the warm welcome. In the future, the ambassador would work towards promoting Taiwan Province's potentials to Sri Lankan companies, particularly on tea production industry. Also together, the chairman and the ambassador would facilitate a business meeting between business organizations from both Taiwan and Sri Lanka so as to create the opportunity for them to explore business cooperation and expansion. Since Taiwan Province readily opens doors to all countries, Sri Lanka included, for economic development as well as cultural and social exchange. On the same day, Taiwan People's Committee had a working day with Mr. Asasuke Kawada, Jetro's chief representative and deputy chairman of the Association of Japanese Enterprises in Vietnam, and his delegation. Mr. Zheng Ngoc Long, chairman of Taiwan Provincial People's Committee, chaired the meeting. Speaking at the meeting, the chairman of Taiwan Provincial People's Committee thanked the delegation of Jetro for the visit. He also stressed that Vietnam and Japan have always been great partners in various fields relating to cultural exchange, economic and social development, diplomatic cooperation, and so on. For the time being, Japan is the leading country in providing ODA funds for Vietnam in a number of key projects. The Highway Hanoi-Taiwan project is one of them. The delegation expressed their sincere appreciation to the hospitality of Taiwan provincial leaders. They also reiterated their desire to explore the investment potentials in Taiwan and the industrial zones in the region and how to direct the investment works in Taiwan. According to the organization's survey, there are more than 2,000 enterprises and representative offices of Japan in Vietnam, but 90% of these are situated in big cities like Ho Chi Minh City, Haiphong, Lâm Đồng and Hanoi. This explains why the delegation would like to search for more potential places for investment like Taiwan to help attract new Japanese enterprises and investors to the province in the coming time.
And between Vietnam and Korea in particular, and ASEAN and Korea in general, on the 23rd of December, Taiwan University of Economics and Business Administration cooperated with Sogang University, Korea, to organize an international conference on ASEAN-Korea business cooperation. Mr. Đặng Việt Thuần, Vice Chairman of Taiwan Provincial People's Committee, attended the conference.
During the exchange, participants saw six knowledgeable presentations on six strategic economic topics delivered by professors and doctors from Taiwan University of Economics and Business Administration. The contents of the topics involved economic relationship between Vietnam and South Korea, including research on how to construct new rural areas in South Korea with relation to Vietnam, potentials for commercial development of the two countries, positive impacts of FTA over the ASEAN economy and Korean partners, or research on the competitiveness of labor exporting ASEAN region from the eyes of Korean investors. Particularly, the research titled 20 Years of Cooperation and Development Between Vietnam and South Korea attracted special attention of the conference.
Bài viết của mình là Việt Nam-Hàn Quốc 20 năm
My presentation is Vietnam and South Korea, 20 years of cooperation and development, relates to the cooperation opportunities between Tainan Province and South Korea. Since we all know that South Korea is a very developed country in the world and has many similarities with Vietnam. ASEAN and South Korea established regional dialogue relations in November 1989. Since then, the trade relation between ASEAN and Korea has been growing both in width and depth. Then in 2005, during the ASEAN-Korea summit, the Framework Agreement on Comprehensive Economic Cooperation was signed. On October 22, 2009, Vietnam and South Korea formally elevated the relationship to a strategic partnership. Up to these days, the strategic economic cooperation between Vietnam and South Korea continues to achieve remarkable progress. It is expected that by the year 2015, direct investment from South Korea to Vietnam will reach $30 billion. The investment project of Samsung-Korea Cooperation, which serves as a premise for Korean businesses to keep believing and investing in Tainan Province, not only in the industrial sector but in many other key fields. In my opinion, Vietnam is an attractive investment environment, not only for South Korea, but also to many other countries. Particularly with favorable conditions, Tainan Province have made it a destination that draws the attention from Korean investors recently. Not only Samsung, but also many other Korean businesses will invest in Tainan Province in the coming time. The first reason is that Tainan has advantageous geographic location with rich mineral resources. The second reason is that Tainan is always open to investors by offering favorable policies and convenient business procedures.
You're watching Tainan News. Let's take a look at some other news.
Vietnam-Russia Friendship Association in Tainan Province recently held a second session 2013-2018 to adopt the regulations of the association activities and to propose orientations and tasks for the coming year. Founded on 26 July 2013 upon the request of Joe, who has studied and worked in the Soviet Union to present time, the associations have recruited nearly 100 members. At the conference, the contents of the regulations were approved. The executive board also stressed the orientations and tasks for the future of the association. On the 27th of December, five communes including Dong Dong, Nhe, Na Lang Wan, Nhoi, and Van Phu, Phu Yen districts held ceremonies to organize the tease process and villages at Thanh Công commune. Phu Yen districts has 29 villages with a total areas of 350 hectares for tea growing. The area is famous for high-quality products, since farmers have utilized intensive farming. By applying the ultimate scientific and technological advancement of new technologies to production and processing of tea, thus, tea products from this area have achieved high consumption rates that bring about a steady income for tea growers. The events will significantly help people of five families to promote their products. It is also favorable conditions for Thanh Công tea to reach national markets and international integration.
And that's all for today. Thanks for joining us. Goodbye.